There are different ways to build, test, and deploy your applications to your development or production environments. Back in the day, we used to just copy a zip file, a WAR file, or the binary files in the web apps directory of our web servers. Then, we have to manually configure and restart our Apache, Nginx, and IBM web servers to reflect the changes. This process is called a manual deployment and is prone to a lot of human errors. There are a lot of moving parts that you have to do by hand, which may take several hours to complete. Worse, provisioning the required virtual web server or a dedicated database cluster will take you weeks or even months to accomplish due to lack of automation. Good thing that nowadays, you can do your deployment in the blink of an eye through the various deployment tools available at your disposal. AWS offers a number of services that provide deployment and management capabilities for one or more aspects of your application lifecycle. These services enable organizations to build and deliver applications faster than their traditional CI/CD workflow. You and your team don't have to spend a lot of time manually provisioning, configuring, updating, monitoring, or securing your AWS resources anymore. These laborious tasks can be programmed into code and easily automated with the different deployment services available in AWS. Some of these services use the concept of Infrastructure as Code, or IAC. An IAC is a process of managing and provisioning your servers, databases, CDNs, and other resources through machine-readable definition files. Simply put, you only need to provide a text-based definition file that will automatically provision the required resources for your application in just one click of a button. The advent of cloud computing enables companies to deploy all their workloads entirely in the cloud. They also have the option to run a hybrid cloud architecture in which they utilize both their physical on-premises resources and cloud services in AWS at the same time. There's even an option now to do a multi-cloud deployment where you deploy your infrastructure to AWS, Azure, Google Cloud, and other public cloud providers simultaneously. You can run both your multi-tier applications and Kubernetes or Docker container cluster almost anywhere, whether it be on the cloud, on-premises, on multiple public clouds, or a combination of all three. Let's discover the different deployment services in this lesson. These services have the capability to provision, configure, deploy, scale, and monitor your cloud architecture without any manual intervention on your part. They are AWS CloudFormation, AWS Elastic Beanstalk, AWS CodeDeploy, Amazon ECS Anywhere, Amazon EKS Anywhere, AWS OpsWorks, AWS Proton, and many more. AWS CloudFormation is a service that enables you to provision and manage your AWS resources using a custom code template. You can create a custom template in YAML or JSON format that defines the AWS resources that you require, like Amazon EC2 instances, Amazon FSx file systems, Amazon Aurora databases, CloudFront distributions, or any other resource. And the AWS CloudFormation service can deploy all of these automatically for you. AWS CloudFormation also comes with a graphic tool called the CloudFormation Designer. This is a drag-and-drop online tool for creating, viewing, and modifying your AWS CloudFormation templates. CloudFormation is the primary infrastructure as code service in AWS. It works like any other IAC tools in the market, like Terraform, Ansible, Chef, and Puppet. The key difference, however, is the additional features that it provides, which are fully compatible with the AWS Cloud. A CloudFormation template deploys your cloud infrastructure resources in a group called a stack. This stack can represent your entire cloud architecture or just its subset. If you have a large multi-tier architecture, you can create multiple templates to represent the different tiers of your enterprise application suite. You can create a CloudFormation template for your presentation layer stack, another template for your application layer stack, and one more for your data layer stack. You can bundle your multiple stacks together into something called a nested stack. In CloudFormation, you can have a root stack with a hierarchy of nested stacks under it. This will effectively make the modules of your infrastructure code to be loosely coupled with each other, which makes the management of each individual stack much easier. Your application layer stack will only contain EC2, EKS, ECS, and other compute resources, while the data layer stack will have RDS, Aurora, DocumentDB, Amazon Neptune, Amazon TimeStream, or any database services. Any change in one of the nested stack won't adversely affect the other stack. Aside from provisioning your resources, Amazon CloudFormation allows you to change, modify, or scale your services that are already deployed in your AWS account. It even has a dry run mode to check your upcoming changes before they're deployed in your cloud environment. This feature is called a change set. Essentially, a change set allows you to see how your changes might impact your running resources before finally implementing them. Say you want to change the name of your Amazon Aurora serverless database. You can create a change set in CloudFormation that will create a new Aurora database and delete the old one. Of course, you will lose the data in the old database unless you've taken a DB snapshot for backup. The change set will show you the upcoming change, so you can plan accordingly before you update your stack. A CloudFormation stack is usually mapped in a single AWS account only, so if you're running your applications in two or more AWS accounts, you can use stack sets. A stack set extends the capability of CloudFormation stacks by enabling you to create, update, or delete stacks across multiple accounts in AWS regions in a single operation. You can select an administrator account in your AWS organization and then choose a particular CloudFormation template for your stack set. This template will be the basis for provisioning the stacks into your selected target accounts. The stack, change set, stack set, and the graphical designer tool are the base feature of the AWS CloudFormation service. There are different services in AWS that extend the capabilities in CloudFormation, namely the AWS Cloud Development Kit and AWS Serverless Application Model. The AWS Cloud Development Kit, or AWS CDK for short, is an open source software development kit for Amazon Web Services. You can use this to programmatically model your AWS infrastructure using TypeScript, Python, Java, .NET, or any other programming languages that you prefer. The AWS Serverless Application Model Service, or AWS SAM, is an open source framework that simplifies the development of your serverless applications on AWS. This is commonly used if your cloud stack is using AWS Lambda, Amazon DynamoDB, API Gateway, and other serverless services. AWS SAM can also have a SAM template that's essentially just an extension of the AWS CloudFormation template. A SAM template has some additional components that make it easier for you to work with serverless services in AWS. Your apps can be stored in the AWS Serverless Application Repository. This repository service makes it easy for developers and companies to deploy, manage, and share their serverless applications in AWS and to the greater public. You can easily publish your serverless apps and share them with the community at large or privately within your organization. AWS Elastic Beanstalk is a managed platform that allows you to upload your application code in AWS and provision the required cloud environment easily. You only need to upload your application package that is written in Java, .NET, PHP, Node.js, Python, Ruby, Go, or Docker, and then Elastic Beanstalk will deploy the necessary resources to run your application. You can either run a web server environment or a worker environment. A web server environment runs a static website, a web app, or a web API that serves HTTP requests, while a worker environment, on the other hand, runs a worker application that processes long-running workloads on demand. The latter also performs tasks on a schedule that you define and can be integrated with the Amazon SQS queue. The AWS Elastic Beanstalk service also uses a configuration file like CloudFormation to automatically deploy and configure your applications. These configuration files in Elastic Beanstalk are stored in the .eb extensions folder. AWS CodeDeploy is a fully managed deployment service that automates your application deployments in AWS. You can deploy your applications to Amazon EC2 instances, Amazon ECS clusters, AWS Lambda functions, and other computing services in AWS. You can even use this to deploy your application to the servers located on your on-premises network. This service is different from AWS CloudFormation, AWS SAM, and Elastic Beanstalk, since you can only deploy your applications to existing compute resources. AWS CodeDeploy does not create AWS resources on your behalf, and is intended for application deployments only. Amazon ECS is a fully managed container orchestration service that supports Docker containers. This orchestration service allows you to easily run containerized applications on a managed cluster that you can control. Basically, container orchestration is an automation tool that reduces the operational effort needed to run your containerized workloads and services. Amazon ECS can automatically orchestrate or control the manual tasks of provisioning, deploying, scaling, networking, and many other tasks, so you don't have to. When you create an Amazon ECS cluster, you can choose whether the compute resources will be deployed or launched in your own VPC, in AWS Fargate, or externally via Amazon ECS Anywhere. A cluster launched in a VPC uses Amazon EC2 instances that are orchestrated and controlled by Amazon ECS. You can use the Amazon CloudWatch Container Insights to monitor your container workloads. If the launch type is AWS Fargate, then your cluster will be serverless, and the computing resources will be fully managed by AWS. Using AWS Fargate can significantly reduce the operating costs of running your containers. If you decide to launch your cluster externally, then your cluster will be run on your own server located on-site through the help of the Amazon ECS Anywhere service. Amazon ECS Anywhere is a feature of Amazon ECS that enables you to run and manage container workloads on your own on-premises infrastructure. You'll still have the same cluster management, workload scheduling, monitoring, and support features in Amazon ECS Anywhere, whether you're running your workload on-premises or in the cloud. This ubiquitous service can help you meet your compliance requirements and scale your hybrid architecture without undermining the previous investments you already have in your on-premises hardware. Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or Amazon EKS, is a managed service that you can use to run Kubernetes on AWS. It's like Amazon ECS, but instead of Docker containers, this service is used for running Kubernetes clusters. Amazon EKS automates the installation, operation, and maintenance of your own Kubernetes control plane, pods, and nodes. You can deploy your Kubernetes cluster in various ways in AWS and can include additional networking add-ons to improve your containerized architecture. A Kubernetes container can be deployed to an Amazon EKS cluster in your AWS account, to Amazon EKS on AWS Outposts, to Amazon EKS Anywhere, and through the Amazon EKS distro. The first option allows you to launch a Kubernetes cluster using managed or self-managed Amazon EC2 nodes that you can customize and control. You can also choose to deploy your Kubernetes pods on AWS Fargate to make the cluster serverless and extremely cost-effective. The second type is Amazon EKS on AWS Outposts, which is a deployment option that uses a physical AWS Outpost rack on your on-premises network to run your Kubernetes workloads. The data plane is also located on-premises, so you can have more control compared with running it exclusively in AWS. Using Amazon EKS Anywhere is another way to deploy your containers on-premises. It works like Amazon ECS Anywhere, which allows you to run your Kubernetes cluster entirely on your own. This means that the hardware, app deployment location, control plane, and data plane are all controlled on your own physical network. This gives you extensive control over all the components of your containerized application suite, while maintaining official support from AWS. The other deployment option that you can choose is Amazon EKS Distro. The word distro simply refers to the distribution of the same open source Kubernetes software deployed by Amazon EKS in the AWS cloud. Amazon EKS Distro follows the same Kubernetes version release cycle as Amazon EKS and is provided to you as an open source project that you can deploy on your own computer or on-site environment. It's similar to the Amazon EKS Anywhere option, except that it does not include support services offered by AWS. AWS OpsWorks is a configuration management service that provides managed instances for your Chef and Puppet-based automation platforms. Chef and Puppet are IAC platforms that automate the manual task of provisioning and configuring your servers. AWS OpsWorks automates how your servers are provisioned, configured, and managed across your Amazon EC2 instances or your own physical servers situated in your corporate building. OpsWorks has three offerings, namely AWS OpsWorks for Chef Automate, AWS OpsWorks for Puppet Enterprise, and AWS OpsWorks Stacks. AWS Proton is a service that automates container and serverless deployments in AWS. It empowers your platform teams and developers to have consistent development standards and best practices. This service is very useful if you have a large number of developers in your organization. AWS Proton enables your developers to deploy container and serverless applications using pre-approved stacks that your platform team manages. It balances control and flexibility in your organization by allowing developers to innovate within the set guardrails that you implement. It also offers a self-service portal for your developers, which contains AWS Proton templates that they can use and deploy. A Proton template contains all the information required to deploy your custom environments and services. You can create an AWS Proton component as well, which provides flexibility to your service templates. These components in AWS Proton provide platform teams with a way to extend core infrastructure patterns and define guardrails for your developers.